We're into the third of a five-year program to re-establish Macquarie Perch into the Ovens River. It's a two-pronged approach. We're putting in fish raised from Fisheries Victoria Snobs Creek Hatchery, and we're also translocating sub-adult and adult fish from Dartmouth Dam. So in the last 3 years, over 60,000 finlings have gone into the Ovens, and we're probably going to be up over 1,100 fish from Dartmouth Dam. So they're the ones translocated from Dartmouth. Well, it's to re-establish the mac perch in the Ovens. So it used to be a co-dominant or dominant species in this mid and lower Ovens, even all the way up the Ovens catchment. It's part of an overall program combined with a heap of other activities, looking at habitat, looking at the riparian vegetation, woody weeds, fish passage, and importantly, there's a huge amount of involvement with community. So it's a real partnership between community and government.
Oh, terrific, yeah. The more people that become aware, particularly kids, the more future we've got for native fish in the system, I think. They'll grow up to understand what's going on.
They're the native fish to Australia and they don't harm our rivers.
Community involvement and awareness is all part of what we're doing today and we've been doing over the last few years. And it's really terrific. We've got so much fantastic cooperation and ownership from community.
I've had a lot of fun and I loved being able to get in the water.
People having an awareness of what's going on and participating, and for kids and adults alike to be able to actually release the fish, brings you that step closer to having ownership, and that's a real understanding. It's been like the first time you handled a frog. It gives you that closer affinity to that species, and being out in the environment, you make a relationship between the fish and the water and habitat and the variables.
And welcome, Everton kids.
Being involved with students from the tech school, CLC students, and these younger students from country schools, it's helping educate them into what the future is and to make sure you look after what we've got. The benefits of removing carp is that they occupy 85% of the biomass of fish in our waterways. So in saying that, they're occupying the space that our native fish would, and they're destroying the habitat and the food chain that the native fish need.
Carp are a terrible introduced species. They muddy up the water, they actually prey on the eggs and juveniles of a lot of our native species.
So each of the large fish that have been put in have got yellow tags, and they've got an individual code or number on them. That means that if anglers catch them, they can practice their safe catch and release techniques, because these fish are protected. But the valuable thing that we can get from angler reports is that we'll find out where the fish have gone to, and we'll know individual numbers, and we'll know individuals and where they've moved to. So it's a really valuable contribution that anglers can make to helping to record and report that information through to us.
Anything to do with fish is a good day for me. The releases, the find out how well we've done over the years. I was involved with the Trout Cod program sort of 10 years ago. Now to be involved with the Maccas and see the results already, I'm pretty stoked actually.
Some of our tagged fish, the larger adult fish, we've had quite a few phoned in from anglers already, and some of them have moved quite a distance from where we released them, so that's really good.
We've just done some surveys recently which have been able to demonstrate that some of the early work in the last couple of years is taking hold. We've still got survivorship of finglings and translocated fish.
So we're up here with an electric fishing boat and we're surveying a pretty large area of the Ovens River, maybe 50, 60 kilometre reach. So we're doing a whole lot of sites from just upstream of Myrtleford all the way down to just below Wangaratta. So we use a pulsed direct current with the electric fishing boat, and it temporarily stuns the fish. We net them at a length and weight, take a little fin clip to see who they are, and let them go again. They come good straight away.
So the genetics, we've taken lots of fin clips from all the fish that have come in. Each individual has been fin clipped so that we can do some work on it to determine the genetics. That's going to enable us to provide information on which fish are contributing to breeding and therefore recruitment. We'll be able to also distinguish between whether or not fish that have been stocked by finglings raised in the hatchery are doing better than the translocated fish.
We do look at that long-term approach where removing woody weeds and inappropriate vegetation from the banks, re-establishing indigenous native vegetation, which can then in the long term contribute to the river, but in the short term when we're required, actually physically going in and placing habitat into the river.
Well, we're re-snagging, which is putting back large in-stream woody habitat into the Ovens River, upstream of Wangaratta, and it's part of an overall 5-year program to re-establish Macquarie Perch into the Ovens. Snags are great for providing food and shelter, the whole food chain of material to help improve the native fish populations.
To know that there's actually been a few macas caught along this stretch of river this year, that's really good.
If we can have a resilient stream with fish populations which are healthy and robust, that can handle everything that nature has to throw at it, and building resilience by having a strong and stable riparian vegetation is one of the keys.